Hi, my name is Zico and I'm a technical specialist at Pico Technology. In this PicoLog 6 video guide, we'll be going through alarms. To demonstrate these features, we'll be using the USB PT104 4-channel PT100/PT1000 temperature data logger, offering the ultimate in resolution and accuracy. It also allows you to measure 2, 3 and 4 wire sensors. And it also allows you to measure resistance and voltage. It has both USB and Ethernet connectivity. We'll also be using the PT100 immersion probes, also known as the SEO14s. To demonstrate alarms, we have two mugs, one with cold water and one with warm water. So to access the alarm menu, we need to go to the top of the channel axes menu, click on the alarm icon, and then click on the add alarm icon. You can now see three types of alarms: threshold, channel disconnected, and custom expression. So start off with threshold. This basically gives you a lower and upper limit that you can set. So in our example, we'll have 20 degrees as our lower limit and 30 degrees as our upper limit, and we'll choose channel 1. So as you can see, by default, play sound continuously is ticked. So what this does basically is, when the alarm condition happens, it will constantly sound. If we untick it, it will only alarm when it enters the alarm condition. So leave it like that by default. And as you can see, you can also have an application run when the alarm triggers. A third option, which you can't see at the moment, is a digital output. So if you have a device like the USB Dr. DAC, you can use its digital output to trigger something. And the last thing we'll look at is hold off. Now hold off, this is the time in the period of time in seconds between the value going out of range and alarming. So this is useful if you've got values that occasionally go out of range. So for example, you're having a defrost cycle in your freezer. And then you can change the color as well of the alarm notification. So if I click on save, and I get our probe, and we go to channel axes there, and put the temperature probe in the cold mug, and wait for it to alarm. So what we can do at this point is, if we go to the alarm menu again, there's two things you can see. We can either mute the alarm, and we can stop the notifications that appear at the bottom. So if I take that probe out and plug it into the, or put it into the mug, the hot mug, and go over here, so as you can see, it's gone into alarm, but you can't hear it or you can't see any notifications at the bottom really. So if I go to the alarm section again and unselect those, you'll hear that alarm again. So I'll just mute that for now. The next alarm that we look at is the channel disconnect alarm. So if we click on add alarm, go to channel disconnected, select the channel that we're interested in, so we'll choose channel 1, and then click on save. And as the name implies, when the channel is disconnected, it will alarm. So if I go to the channel axes menu here, and if we unplug the unit, you can see it alarming. And we plug it back in again, it stops alarming. Now we can also do the same by unplugging the temperature sensor. And then if we plug it back in again, and that's channel disconnected alarms for you. The last alarm we'll go through is custom expressions. So if we go to alarms, add alarm, and select custom expression, This requires a Boolean output, i.e. true or false, which you can define with a combination of various functions that you can find more information about on our website. So if I go advanced, it opens up all these options for you. So what we're going to do in this case is we're going to have two channels, channel 1 and channel 2. And we're going to want channel 1 to be below 21 degrees Celsius and channel 2 to be above 30 degrees Celsius. So if I select channel 1, say below 21 and channel 2 greater than 30, and then click on save, and then go to channel axes. So we'll get channel 1 and we'll put it in the actual cold mug. So as you can see, channel 1 is below 21 degrees Celsius, but it isn't alarming because channel 2 has to be above 30. So if we put the second probe in channel, in the second mug, you can see now it alarms. And if we take, just to prove it, take the actual channel 1 probe out and put it into the second mug, you can see it isn't alarming and it proves that the Boolean expression works. This concludes this PicoLog 6 video on alarms. For more information on the features that we covered today, you can find this information on the help file in PicoLog 6, or you can visit our website for more information. Thank you for watching and look forward to seeing you in the next video.